If the Crunch beat the Attack tonight, Kansas City will be trading in their soccer shoes for a set of golf clubs. But don't count out the team with the best regular season record. And come visit our gallery. It's only a bit louder than what you're used to. If Cleveland wins tonight, the humidor will be full, and the crown jewel will be theirs for the second time in 3 years. Bought and sold to the highest bidder.
$300,000. Sold.
From the Cleveland State University Convocation Center, it's Game 6 of the NPSL Finals. The Kansas City Attack trying to stay alive, the Cleveland Crunch trying to win a championship. And the Crunch has been put in this position by a big win in Game 5. They held a big lead, then held off Kansas City, running in late on a 10-point spree. But the Crunch came out with a victory by 4 points, and they sit in this position. Hi, everybody. I'm Ed Vasinic. You know, it wasn't that long ago that the city of Cleveland served as the punchline to some unflattering jokes, and the sports fans in this town didn't have a whole lot to cheer about. But all that has changed over the last couple of years. Some renovations downtown have beautified the city, and the sports fans here are getting used to winning more than losing. The Cleveland Indians set this town on its ear by nearly winning the World Series last season, and the Cleveland Crunch set the tone, winning the 94 NPSL Championship, giving the city their first championship in 30 years. Now, the Crunch has been to the NPSL Championship 3 of the last 4 years, while the Kansas City Attack are looking for their second championship. They won it back in 1993, and they were up in this series 2-0, but have lost their last three, their first 3-game losing streak of the entire season. My broadcast partner is Art Kramer, and Art, I think when you look at this series, you got to go back to Game 5 and the insertion of a very key player for Cleveland.
Well, no doubt about it. Through the first 4 games, Cleveland had not really been a factor on the restarts, and they win a lot of games off restart goals. And Zoran Karic, who hadn't taken a shot with his left foot in the first 4 games, suddenly cracked these 2 unbelievable right-footed shots off the restarts that were really key for Cleveland winning Game 5 and sending here at home field advantage of Game 6.
You know, Art, one of the trends that has developed in this series is one team or another has gotten on a huge run. Unfortunately for Kansas City, their runs have been late in the game.
Well, we talked to Coach Zoran Savic from Kansas City. He told us that they haven't been in front the whole series. They've played from behind in virtually the first 5 games, and whenever you do that, really takes a lot out of you, both emotionally and physically. So look for Kansas City to try to come out, play it one shift at a time, and get off to that ever-important good start.
Well, the Cleveland Crunch have gotten production from their big stars, Hector Marinara and Zoran Karic. Kansas City, on the other hand, has struggled a little bit. Guys like Brian Haynes, Kevin Ketters, and Goran Hunyak had big games in the first 2 games, combining for 33 points. But in the last 3 games, those 3 guys have put up only 16 points. They need to gear it up. And here's how Kansas City will start for Game 6. It'll be Brett Phillips in goal, Nate Hauser and Jim Schwab. He's injured with that hamstring, but will start Kevin Ketters in the midfield with Goran Hunyak and Lee Tschantrin. For the Cleveland Crunch, it'll be Otto Orff in goal, Oskar Dragicevic and Scott Schweitzer, and the line of Tommy Tanner, Zoran Karic, and Hector Marinaro. And before we start, let's go down to Greg Mays for some last-minute details. Greg?
After this series, Bruce Miller said, in fact, we've won a game on the road. That was a big obstacle. Let's take advantage of it. This atmosphere tonight is perhaps the greatest, most exciting atmosphere we've ever seen in a pregame in a Cleveland State University Convocation Center game. Kansas City senses that. They've got to take this crowd out of the game early and move along and win. The key is to score early and get the crowd out of the game. Ed?
All right. Thanks a lot, Greg. This crowd is charged up and ready to go. A lineup change. Defensively, it'll be Wes Wade and Eddie Carmine. Instead of those 2 defenders, we set your way, and we're just about set. The officials for tonight's game, Tom Landy and Rich Herron down on the floor. It is showtime in Game 6. The Crunch in the white, the Kansas City Attack in the all blue, and a foul called right away against KC.
And a guy to watch early in this game for Kansas City is Lee Tschantrin. He loves these situations, tries to come in and be the bad boy and spoil the party here in Cleveland. Watch for Tschantrin to mix it up early and try to get things stirred up. He loves it when the crowd boos him.
Yeah, he's sporting a bit of a more clean-shaven look than we've seen in the past.
maybe to change the luck. Here come the crunch. Marinero has trouble with that ball from Schweitzer. Scott Schweitzer controls back to Oskar Dragicevic and into a posting Zoran Karic. He's knocked down by Wes Wade, and here come the attack. Running 3-on-3 with Brian Haynes. He lights it up from long range. Blocked up and out. Restart. First game, six of the NPSL playoffs in the history of this league. We've only been going seven games for the last 2 years, and last year the St. Louis Ambush swept the Harrisburg Heat four straight. Wes Wade dumps it in. Carmine had trouble. Deshantrin scores! There's the guy you mentioned, Art Lee. Deshantrin with the head ball. 2-0 KC.
Well, Deshantrin loves these types of situations. Big crowd here, likes to be the villain, and he starts out a good start off a restart. Wade puts it in play. Kansas City keeps it alive at the back post. And watch Deshantrin on the left side of your screen. Just be very opportunistic in the box and head one over Otto to give Kansas City the early lead.
Lee Deshantrin, 27-year-old from Albany. Big goal for the Kansas City attack. Art talked about taking the crowd out. Well, there's nothing that makes it easier. 41 seconds into the game.
And Cleveland, on the other hand, needs to really keep their emotions in check the whole game long. The big crowd, the guys really came out in the warm-up and were inspired by the cheers they got, but they can't get too high or too low all game long. They got to really play on an even keel, and now, Ed, they get their first restart opportunity on an over and back.
Over and back was the call, no foul on that play against Karic, so the Crunch actually in a bit better of a position to restart in the middle of the floor.
And here's where Karic is going to come out. We didn't see him in this position in the first four games. He was on the left side, but that injured right knee of his is feeling better.
He has an opening there, and rockets it into the seats. 11 points for Zoran Karic. In game five goals, 1 3-pointer, 4 2-pointers. For those of you who haven't been following the series, he wasn't getting a normal shift because of that knee just coming out for restart.
Hadn't even tried a shot with the left foot through the first four games, and then at a pivotal time in game five, decided to try it, scored that great 3-point goal.
Deshantrin and Tima go to the corner. Kevin Ketters, he's one of the guys who had a huge game in the first couple of games in Kansas City. Brett Phillips, Eddie Carmine has an opening. He will take advantage. Great ball. Here's Brian Haynes on his off wing, so to speak. He's a left-sided player. John Limniotis over to Eddie Carmine. And great ball possession from Casey.
This Cleveland offense is really amazing. Kansas City had the best defense in the league, held their opponents under 11 points per game, but Cleveland has scored close to 20 points on the average in the first five games. In fact, the lowest total they've scored is 17. Kansas City needs to try to keep better possession of the ball and really take their offense out of the game by possession on their half.
Lee Deshantrin making troubles for the Crunch deep in their own end as Tima had to work very hard to try and get it out of trouble. Here the Crunch finally come with Doug Miller. He's on the second line with Henry Gutierrez and Chris Hanser. The left-footed shot block. Hanser gave it a go. Oh, trouble for Phillips in what looked like a very easy ball to handle when it started out.
Routine shot for Phillips. He did give up a rebound, but no Cleveland player crashing into the box.
Here's Wes Wade. Kansas City definitely has lost a little bit. Wade having to move back defensively, replacing Schwab. Wade and Deshantrin were the tandem up front that created a lot of havoc and created some goals out of nothing.
Well, when Kansas City has the lead, they can afford to slow things down, as you see them doing here. They've trailed in all five games of the series and have really trailed from the outset.
Ball played in for Jeff Rogers, and Carbonara didn't get it all that cleanly back to Orff, but it made it to its destination. There's the outlet. Here comes Dragicevic. He can light it up from three-point land, missed wide. And Marinero unable to corral the rebound. Here comes Goran Hunyak. Hunyak over 100 points in the regular season. Oh, he has an opening, cuts it back. Here he comes, makes the shot. Composure stopped by Orff, who is on his back.
Well, Goran with like seven or eight nice touches to set himself into the middle of the field. Good overlapping run by Deshantrin to give him that space.
If Otto Orff picks up a victory tonight, he will set a record for the most victories by a goalkeeper in a playoff run. He has 8 right now. The record is 8. held by Jamie Schwanner of the St. Louis Ambush. Tommy Tanner fouled. Now he's looking for the space. He went to ask Rich Heron, and then when Heron moved in, he played the ball. Can't do that.
Well, the key is you have to ask for the referee to mark off 15 feet.
And then wait. Zoran Karic. 84 points in 27 games during the regular season. Otto almost paid for a giveaway his teammates made at midfield.
And Ketters, as you said, almost made him pay. Had the right trajectory, but just shot it wide. That would have only been a two-pointer because he was on his own side of the half line.
Marinaro and Wade go to the corner. Hector tries to spin. He gets turned around by Wes Wade. And here comes Ketters, 27-year-old from Quincy, Illinois.
One of the big keys for Kansas City, Ed, is how quickly they get back in transition from offense to defense, because Cleveland loves to counterattack you. They'll let you play 4v3 to take the 2-on-1 at the other end.
Nice move by Eddie Carmi. I think there's an underrated player for you. Eddie Carmi's left foot. Rogers in front. He missed it wide.
Oh, I don't know how that one stayed out.
Here is Brian Haynes. He shoots one into the seats. You know, something that we need to look at in this series is Kansas City has lost, but they have not failed to create chances. They've had a lot of chances, and you worry more when you're not getting those chances.
Well, there's so much talent on both these teams that offensively, they're both going to get their chances. It's really the team that finishes their chances the best is going to win each game. We've really seen that through the first five.
Henry Gutierrez. Now chases the dump in from Tima. Nate Hauser there first, and a foul called against Hauser. The Crunch will have a restart deep in the corner. Gutierrez, 114 points last season, a rookie of the year, 95 this year. Missed the first eight games with a broken foot.
And more importantly, has really come to life in the playoffs. Last year in the playoffs, only scored 7 points in six games, but has over 40 points already through the first five in this series.
Harris tried to curl it in, and I don't know if Henry saw it. Here's the volley! Just over the crossbar. Carbonero will take it down and hold off Haynes. The Chantrit was lurking. Trying to maybe double team, but never got there. Karich has trouble with Jason Farrell, and a foul called against Karich. Ryan Haynes in the midfield. Haynesy, the all-time leading scorer in Attack history. He was their first ever draft choice and a rookie of the year. Now Goran Hunya. You saw what he could do moments ago. Jeff Rogers has that one skip off of his head. Chris Hanser, only a rookie, flips it back down. And the long distribution. Doug Miller with Carmine on him. Tried to play for Gutierrez. That hit Tom Landy, the official. And Miller will have to do a whole lot of work to try and possess. Finally, somebody comes up with control of that, and it's the Crunch. Great ball from Hanser. Gutierrez cross-court and picked off. Here's Hanser again. Plays to Carbonero. He's a left-footer, moving it on Rogers. Shot it wide. The rebound slapped out by Phillips. And back on it is Carbonero. Crunch showing a bit of possession skill here.
Kansas City all night long. It's going to have to watch the restarts.
Early KC lead. We'll be back. Advocetic and Art Kramer back in Cleveland. An opening for Karich coming forward. Slid it right side. Goal! Hanser!
Well, the goal for Chris Hanser in the Crunch, but great vision on the part of Zoran Karich. Watch the Z-man initially beat the Kansas City defender on the dribble, and then spot Hanser out of the corner of his right eye. A great ball, and Hanser finishes it low under Phillips. But credit to Z-man Zoran Karich with a pretty setup to get Cleveland on the board.
23-year-old rookie from Canada, Chris Hanser, his fifth goal of the playoffs. We've got a tie game at two apiece. Kansas City called for a foul deep in the Cleveland end, and Oscar Dragicevic will put it in play. Bruce Miller behind the Crunch bench his first season. If the Crunch wins the championship, he will become the first rookie coach to do it since Zoran Savic did it
back in 1993.
And he'll be the first guy to tell you that his job is a heck of a lot easier when Zoran Karic is in the lineup healthy. And you saw what Z can do one-on-one and just break a defense down individually, beat two men and then drew the defender to him and found Hanser all alone at the far post.
There's a ball chipped Brian Haynes' way. He tries to hold off Schweitzer. Scott poked in, couldn't come away with it. And carry on. Nisevich held out with it. Now we're keeping it back on. Don't play long. Carriage is open, but Wade recovered in the nick of time. Now lead to Shantrin. He has the Kansas City goal. Wade was making an overlapping run, and Shantrin never got it there.
Well, you've got to be careful when you try to play 4-on-3 against Cleveland. As you said, Wade was making the overlapping run, but you can't give the ball away. Cleveland will kill you 2-against-1 the other way.
There's Hunyak's magic again. Ketters with time. He scores! Kevin Ketters with a two-pointer. It's 4-2, KC.
Well, Otto Orff was screened on that play, and he couldn't see and dove to his right. And that gave Ketters all the room in the left side of the goal as that ball got past Schweitzer. But it was Ketters who used Schweitzer as a screen. Now, if you can see Otto at the bottom of your screen just taking a dive to his right, he couldn't even see the ball. And Ketters saw the space and put it home perfectly.
A Ketters goal has the Attack ahead. This place is packed looking for a crunch championship, but Kansas City will not let this get away without a fight.
Once again, Coach Zoran Savic told us they need to get out to a good start. It's a lot easier emotionally and physically when you're playing in front as opposed to playing from behind, which Kansas City has done in the first 5 games.
Some nice work from Chris Hanser. He can't get past the last mark, however, and the Attack break out. Crunch defense. Carbonera tries to pull his way through. It pops out onto the foot of Goran Hunyak. And in the early stages, Goran Hunyak has created a whole lot for Kansas City. Played in the corner. Jason Farrell had trouble keeping his feet, but a foul called against the Crunch.
Now, what happened there was Hunyak was trying to play the 1-2, and I believe it was Gutierrez who just stepped in front of Goran, which created the obstruction. And Kansas City's got a dangerous restart, already up 4-2.
Kevin Ketters will wait for Tom Landy to move that ball back to 15 feet required. There's the whistle. Plays it back. Eddie Carmine's left foot just over the bar. Haynes has to scramble to get that under control, and they'll have to hold off Doug Miller. Miller's still poking away. Carmine stepped in, and a foul call against Kansas City. Eddie Carmine is so smooth. A lot of times he gets overlooked because he just does his job all the time.
Well, they've got the forwards to put the ball in the goal. Carmine knows his role, and that's to play solid defense. He, Limnaitis, Schwab, those three guys really need to stay at home for Kansas City and let the other guys go forward and score goals.
Henry Gutierrez in the corner. John Limnaitis pushing him back. Hanser and Ketters. Hanser has it get caught between his feet. And a foul called against the Crunch. KC will restart. An early ball to Shantrin behind the defense. Here he comes, the goal. He shoots and scores. Lead to Shantrin. Snuck one in near side. 2 goals for that guy. Kansas City has opened up a 4-point lead. And Bruce Miller is not letting this go any farther.
No, it doesn't like the space that Kansas City is being allowed to play with. You see there, Tima just too late in recovering, and just a low drive by Deshantret beats Otto to the near side, and Deshantret with a great start, 2 goals for Kansas City.
While Bruce Miller gets things straight, we'll slip away and return. No doubt, Lee Deshantret has been a key early on.
Well, you see Deshantret just hit that near post drive, shot that Otto probably should have saved, but you see Coach Bruce Miller wasting no time. That leads directly to a timeout, and good timeout by Miller to try to stop some of this momentum that KC has going.
Well, Bruce Miller has had his say, and we're back to action in game 6. Told you early on that Kansas City had not lost 3 straight games the entire season. Here
Here's Karich with room to work. The pass for Gisevic. Coming in. Puts it across. Nobody there. Marinero will scramble to get it under control. Casey, there's over and back. Casey had a couple of two-game losing streaks. And we'll check in with Greg Mace. Greg?
Martin, Ed, you guys talked about Bruce Miller really taking control as a coach as the season went on. He is in these guys' faces. He said the last goal was inexcusable. They're turning their backs to the goal. Bruce Miller continues to fire his team up, unlike perhaps in the early part of the season when he wasn't quite sure perhaps what to say. It was his first year as an indoor soccer coach. Now he is all over this championship team.
The crunch attacking with Karich, who had some words for Tom Landy, and I don't know exactly what his gripe was. But here comes Kevin Ketters against Tommy Tanner.
Getting back to what Greg just said, he knows how hard they have worked to gain this home field advantage. To steal one in Kansas City was a big accomplishment. He doesn't want to give away this game here.
Karich with Phillips. Out of his goal, Marinero is open on the left side, and V went the more direct route.
I'm sure the other thing he's telling them is, let's keep our composure. We're down four. That's nothing here in this building. You know how quickly that we can score points. Keep our composure, boys. No silly penalties. And let the game come to us.
There's another guy behind the defense. Hauser, instead of shooting, tried to put it across. And that hit traffic. Now the race. Doug Miller and Westwade. Both of these guys can fly. This time it was Westwade. That was a bit faster to the ball.
Well, Wade's in the back because of the injury to their captain, Jim Schwab. And you see the great catch-up speed that Wade possesses.
And all fairness to Doug Miller, he's working on a broken knee. Got some cartilage and ligament damage in his left knee. And has had trouble with the speed he's normally used to. Hauser, very well defensively there, walked around Carbonara. Team over to help the slide tackle. Shanzer tries to play early. He was fouled by Doug Miller. Look at the third-year player, 23-year-old Nate Hauser.
And watch the outstanding tackle by Tim Tima, who holds virtually every defensive record in this league, as well as four championship rings, three with Canton and one here with Cleveland 2 years ago.
Well, we have not had a repeat champion in the league since back in the late 80s when Canton strung together three in a row, but since 1991 there's been a different winner every year.
Restart time.
And there's a look. Chicago started the run of change in 91.
And the coaches picked these two teams to get to the championship last year, and you see St. Louis snuck in there and won it in a four-game sweep over Harrisburg, but the two teams that the coaches had picked 2 years ago are here in the finals this season.
Bunyak again with some magic. Unfortunately, just a bit behind Kevin Ketters. 4-point lead for Kansas City.
And I'm sure a relief to Coach Zoran Savic. He talked about the need to having to play in front, to getting that early lead, and they've done that here in the first quarter.
Karich moving in on Hunyak. Hunyak with a slide tackle, but he fouled him just before he could get there. And Karich will put it in play from the corner. 34-year-old Zoran Karich. Zoran off the board. Tima with the toe poke. Another attempt that's over the bar. Oh, Tim had a couple of shots there. Was unlucky in front of the goal.
Well, Tima in a bit of an unfamiliar position for him, right in front of the goal, had two good chances. And then he made sure Phillips wasn't going to get that quick outlet as he pinned him up against the boards.
Early ball from Schweitzer. Here comes Karich, left footer blocked by Wade, who trailed. Ball free. DeShandrin and Schweitzer go after it, and DeShandrin came away. He's got a streak in Brian Haynes. Now help off the bench from Lofton. Tanner stepped in. Casey carries on around a mark. Dragicevic can't catch it. Numbers for Casey. And the pass is bad. It slows down the rhythm, but they carry on.
Now you're starting to see some of that team speed Kansas City possesses.
Lofton and Dragicevic. Brian Lofton, 12 points in game one. The second you made. Oh, there's a giveaway. Here comes Tanner and Karich. Karich to Tanner. Big stop by Phillips.
Well, Phillips fails his team out because there was confusion along the Kansas City bench on that change. And Cleveland came in 2-0.
A lot of times this is dangerous. Carmine missed.
How many times do you see a team miss at one end and then the other team come and score at the other?
Rodgers dancing with Zoran Karic. They get it back. A foul called against KC. Unfortunate. Here's the giveaway and to go.
And it was confusion at the Kansas City bench just before that, but Phillips comes up with a big save. You saw Phillips go down early, Ed. Had Tanner lifted that ball, he would have gotten it by the KC netminder.
I know one thing. This game isn't going to be as easy for Zoran Karic as game five was. Might have caught the attack a bit by surprise for his effort there, but he's not going to get any freebies tonight. DeForest Tanner can't get it past him again.
Well, once again, second time in a row, Tanner's elected to go low. And both times, Phillips has come up big.
Eloy Salgado on for his first shift and a foul called against Carbonera. Brett Phillips was big in game two.
And look at all the space Tanner has in front as Wade just gave him the space. But Phillips, quite luckily, caught that one between his knees.
He didn't save it. He trapped it, Art. Eloy Salgado had a couple of goals in game five. Late season acquisition from the Chicago Power. The third team that Eloy's played with this season. Tanner walked around a mark and another one. Now a race to the ball. Puniak first back. They're going to call over and back a deflection. And Gorin actually could have played that earlier, but he thought it was last touched by Cleveland.
Well, one way to keep the great Zoran Karic off the scoreboard is not to give away restarts. And Kansas City now giving away a few too many in their own zone. As this is Zoran's specialty.
Here comes Dragicevic, blocked by Hunyak. They'll do it again.
Now, the ball goes over to where it was last deflected by the defender. A lot of times they like to chip over the top to Marinaro. Hector now is walking into the middle of the box. He's going to change positions with Dougie Miller.
Dragicevic to Karic's left. Zoran directed traffic. He needs a seam to get it. Headball Gutierrez and Phillips right where he needed to be. There's the distribution. Dragicevic got it momentarily. Hauser stepped into him strong.
Well, Oscar got caught on the wrong side of the ball that time and a smart foul not to allow Kansas City to have numbers going forward.
The four-point lead for Kansas City late in the first quarter. Pressure on Phillips. Bumps it diagonally and a foul called against Hunyak. Arthur calling this game very tightly.
Well, I think it's smart too with the big crowd. Want to keep things tight early.
Gisevich can't, or that was Gutierrez who couldn't get up and get that one.
Kansas City would be wise to keep possession for this final 25. You don't want to allow Cleveland to have a chance to score in the final seconds after you've played a fine first quarter.
Doug Miller against Carmine. Here's a race. Carmine nipped it away. Miller carries on. A crowd of blue shirts. That should be a dangerous play. They let it go. Tima gets it back, and there's the horn. Kansas City draws first blood here thanks to that man. Lead to Shantrin, a pair of goals, and his guys ahead. A big crowd here expecting to celebrate a championship, but Kansas City has other ideas. They lead by four, and we'll head down to the bench area again and speak with Greg Mace. Greg?
Well, Art Bruce Miller is a little bit more optimistic now. He still wants his team to start diving after balls, playing better defensively. But Miller just said, look, you're starting to take control of this game offensively, and that's what we got to do and get this big sellout crowd back into the game. Bruce Miller is aggressively coaching, knowing that he does not want to go back to Kansas City.
There's a look at the faces, saves. Brett Phillips, 8-1 over Otto Warp. And if you remember back to game two, the Crunch had a load of opportunities to put that one away in KC, but it was Brett Phillips who came up big time after time.
Well, it really was in that game, and Phillips and Otto Orff, his counterpart for Cleveland, have both been outstanding in the series. We knew goalkeeping was going to be a big key, and Phillips coming up big here in the first quarter for Kansas City. You see the first half scoring in the finals. Cleveland really outscored Kansas City in the first half, but a good start by Kansas City. What Coach Zoran Savic alluded to before the game, the need to get out to a good start, and they lead here 6-2.
Here comes Goran Hudjak, who in my mind was a big factor in the first quarter. Deshantre scores a hat-trick for Deshantre. It's 8-2 Kansas City.
Well, Deshantre putting on a clinic in how to make an overlapping run as he just beats Marinaro down the field. Deshantre coming behind the runner with the ball. And look at Deshantre coming behind Hunyak. Nobody stays with him. Goran puts the perfect pass, and Deshantre with a hat trick here just after one quarter of play, but a great overlapping run. And Ed, that's really a great way to create scoring chances, overlapping runs, give and goes, and takeovers.
Oh, we might never see Lee Deshantre with a mustache again.
Yeah, Lee sporting it through the first five games, shaved it off, and already has three goals here in just over one quarter of play.
A six-point lead for Kansas City in a foul call against Tanner deep in his own end.
Give Hunyak a lot of credit as well to wait for Deshantre to complete his run, commit the defender, and Deshantre had all day to beat Otto up high.
I think making the defender commit was the key there because they were shading that pass, and then Hunyak made the step toward goal, forcing the defender to commit, giving Deshantre that opening.
I like the forcing the defender to commit, but I like the running off the ball even more.
Ball goes over the head of everybody. Orff will scoop it up. Otto has 7 points in the playoffs. Head ball by Marinaro. Hector was kept off the score sheet in the first quarter of play. Carriage only with an assist. Gutierrez got a head on it. He's going to hop out, and that will be a free kick for Kansas City. Back where Gutierrez hit it with his coconut. Goran Hudjak with 2 assists. Tonight, he came into the game with 37 points.
I think you'll see Kansas City, out of tremendous respect to Cleveland's offense, try to possess the ball a little bit more here in the second half.
Deshantre looking for 4. Couldn't turn it that time. Schweitzer will bring it out. Both teams right now playing without their captains. Foul against Djurdjevic. Jim Schwab is dressed and on the bench for Kansas City, hampered by a hamstring pull. This is Kevin Ketters, the crunch captain. Andy Schmetzer had his cheekbone broken in the divisional semifinals by Buffalo and has not played since.
Good strength on the ball that time by Hunyak. Shows you how to shield the ball with two men on you.
That was Todd Dasoski playing that one down and scooped up by Brett Phillips.
And this nice start by Kansas City is really a tribute to the experience that they have on their team. They've got guys that have been in this situation before, guys like Haynes, Wes Wade, who's won 5 championships in his day.
It's a handball or foul against the crunch. Kansas City will get another crack at it from the restart in deep. Haynes and Ketters on the ball. Djurdjevic and Gutierrez in the wall. Ketters is going to take a timeout. Kansas City with the only goal of the quarter. They have extended their lead to 6. Soccer, gear, and attire. The official catalog of the NPSL is the Eurosport catalog. You can get in on all that great stuff by dialing up 1-800-447-0570. KC will put it back in play with a restart, similar to a corner kick here. The crunch has never led in this game. Ketters, a couple of fakes. Now Carbine scores! Eddie Carbine along the carpet. And It's now an 8-point lead for KC.
That play seemed like it took forever to develop, but Cleveland not reacting defensively, all three players just standing still, and Carmine actually takes a little double pump before he shoots. Once again on the restart, Carmine's gonna make the first run with Haynes trailing, and they just touch it there. Watch Carmine strike it first time into the far side, but Cleveland not closing quickly. The guy on the side of the wall has got to step off and try to close that shot. He doesn't move, and they beat Otto to the far post.
It's an 8-point run and an 8-point lead. Eddie Carmine's 2-point goal. He has 3 points in the game and 11 for the playoffs. Fourth round pick of the Attack in 1992.
Well, Kansas City capitalizing on something Cleveland likes to do, and that's restart goals. And I tell you what, Ed, they've really taken this big Convocation Center crowd right out of the game here in the first half, as these fans are just waiting for something to cheer about.
Greg Mace has something for us down at the KC bench, Greg.
Well, they're very confident right now, Ed. Zoran Savic is obviously not having to shout and get in their face like Bruce Miller is. As you said, Jim Schwab is not playing. He's still bothered by the hamstring. He could get out there if he's needed desperately, but right now they've got such a big lead, he doesn't have to. But as I just said, boy, this team is very, very confident. They're putting on an offensive clinic.
We talked about the runs in this series. They've come in 12 and 13 point bunches. Right now KC is on an 8-0 run.
They really have been important throughout this series. You see some of the different runs we've seen through the first five games. And as Greg Mace was talking, Kansas City had a couple more chances. Rogers right at the far post, should have even put one more away.
Tanner holding off Hunyak. Here comes Tanner, walked into a crowd. They try a give and go. Gets busted up. Pima just a step shy. Look out, Rogers is open. Over to cut him off is Schweitzer. Jeff will look for some help and finds it in Ketters. Ketters and Tanner, a couple of the finer young talents in the league.
Kansas City can afford to be very patient right now with this 8-point lead. Make Cleveland chase them. Really try to expend some energy playing defense.
I think it's so important, the crowd factor that we talked about, and then you get into, is it the chicken or the egg, which came first? Does the crowd get going to get the team in, or does the team need to go on a little run to get this crowd in?
The team definitely needs to get the crowd into it. Can't wait around for your crowd to help you out if you don't give them anything to cheer about.
DeChantre has hit every ball on the screws tonight as he fouls Tim Tima. He had 100 points two seasons ago, 78 this year, and he has 6 tonight already. Karich coming ahead. He looped it over the head of Marinaro.
DeChantret does it the old-fashioned way, Ed. Strong, hard work rate.
I thought you were going to say he earns it.
He certainly does earn it, but through hard work. And it's a quality you'd like to see more younger players work at is their work rate.
Ryan Haynes off the boards. Look out for the crunch. Gutierrez there. Tima comes away quickly to Marinaro. Picks it ahead. Carriage in a run. Race. And Hauser reaches there. Has to get by Marinaro. Can't. Quick ball touches. Carriage. Marinaro. He just hit it.
You won't see that very often. Marinaro misfiring from about 10 feet away. But it was a giveaway by Kansas City in their own zone to set this chance up. And Hector trying to side foot it. Just leaned back a tad, went over the top, and look at the setup again.
Oh, man, with that space and that ball, you're exactly right. Marinaro doesn't miss those too often. 94 points in 12 playoff games.
And we've said it all series long, and it's the team that finishes their chances, because both teams are going to get a load of chances with the offensive quality.
Now you say 94 points in 12 games for Hector, and you don't even blink an eye, but think about it. Guys have scored 94 points in an entire season, that's huge.
Yeah, if you score 100 points in a season, you know, you're looking to renegotiate your contract, and you're going to ask for the world next season. He did it in, what, 12 games in the playoffs? I wouldn't be surprised to see him top 100 before this game's over.
Otto Orff, who has a three-point goal in this series. And to Todd Nisoski, played the boards. Gutierrez tried to spin toward goal, couldn't control the ball while he was doing it. Hunyak got himself in trouble. Hands are after the ball, so as Hauser played the boards and took a KC hop. Quickly, Phillips gets it ahead to Ketters. And a whistle. The whistle came from the bench, but here, game seven could come up if Kansas City pulls out the victory here, and we'll have it for you on the deuce.
And now Coach Zoran Savic upset about something on that Kansas City bench. I believe there may have been too many men on the field. And they got called with this in game five at a critical point when they were trailing by 3 points. And now once again here in game six, with everything going their way, Ed, if this changes the momentum, it's going to be a power play with no shootout. But once again, it's something that can really change the momentum here with Kansas City having everything going their way in the first half up to this point.
Well, the whistle definitely came from the Sid Goodrich area. And Greg Mace probably has a clear idea of what happened. Greg?
Well, Rogers and Schwab have said, listen, there are only four guys on the field. We were changing. They said, how could you possibly call this? It wasn't an extra man. We only had four, and obviously the officials see it a little bit differently.
Okay, thanks, Greg. Either way, it's going to be a Cleveland power play, and the Crunch has done very well with the man up in the playoffs, scoring 9 of 17. The Crunch 6 of 9 there in Kansas City defensively with a man down.
And you see the 19 power plays, the most allowed by any team, but Kansas City, keep in mind, has that great team speed, and you got to be aware of them when they're on the man down, because they can score shorthanded goals.
And they did a couple of games ago, and it was that guy, Wes Wade, in game four who had a shorthanded goal. Here comes Karich. He's got time and space. Here's Gutierrez across. His connections, Karich will knock it into the seats. And KC will have a free kick.
Well, Jim Schwab, their captain, is coming out for his first shift, and that's on the man down. We had not seen Schwab up to this point, but it looks as if Schwab's going to play on their man down unit.
You know, that's a bit surprising to me for a guy who can't run at full pace, and he's got to cover more ground. Brett Phillips went out of the area or took too long to put the ball in play, so the Crunch is going to get a restart.
And when Kansas City puts two men in the wall on this restart, Karich likes to shoot directly. Let's see how many they put in there. They've got two. Zoran likes to shoot him first time in this situation.
Here it is, scores!
And you see Phillips not happy about that 5-second call. And it's a 1-point goal on the power play, a restart goal, as it was Karich to Marinaro, as Hector found the target on this one. Remember, put it over the top just earlier. But it was this mistake here by Phillips. Let's count it. 5 seconds is all you have.
And it gave the Crunch the restart. Marinaro on the power play.
And we've talked about runs all series long. And it's a Kansas City penalty, a bench penalty, that could provide Cleveland with some momentum here in the second quarter. Let's see how much Cleveland can take advantage of that mistake.
Here comes Carmine, 43 playoff goals for Hector, 2-on-1 for the Crunch. Karich waits for the ball. Haynes is trying to get back in the play. He eliminates it. No, he doesn't. Here comes help from Tanner. Ryan Haynes, it's a big work for KC.
Hector just waited a little bit too long on that one. He was looking to try to get the ball to his partner, Karich, but Kansas City took that passing lane away, forced Hector to the outside.
There's a giveaway. Marinaro holds off Wade, comes the goal, plays it back, and the runs were going on the wrong paths. Kansas City in some trouble. They're going to say no over and back. They got out of it.
Got numbers, Ed.
Here's Rogers. He'll lead the attack to the D, cut it back,
Hunyak waves, oh, he hit the bar!
But Hunyak will never rush anything in front of goal. And I don't know how he missed that one from the left side.
Hunyak with another move forward, an opening again.
Oh my!
Yes!
Oh, what a goal by Goran Hunyak. You talk about making defenders flop around like fish out of water. Hunyak put on a one-on-one clinic there. Let's just take another look, if we can, at the great work by Goran Hunyak. You won't see prettier one-on-one skill than this, as he had everybody going down the wrong way.
Watch and enjoy.
Well, no doubt about it. Zoran Karic gets stripped along the boards, and then Goran Hunyak does the rest. Beautiful individual work by number 9 in blue as he beats Tanner to the right. Fakes the shot and cuts back. And look at him just draw the defense the wrong way, sends everybody the wrong way, and what excellent finish by Hunyak. And you see, not Norhaus behind there, but Hunyak did do it in Cleveland's house on that one.
Even more impressive was he missed that opening moments ago, which a lot of players you would think would tend to rush the next time because he took so much time, but there's the skill and the experience of Goran Hunyak.
Well, not only rush, but hide.
Yeah.
Sometimes when when forwards miss, you don't see him for another good quarter or two, but not Hunyak. Veteran player, misses the one opportunity, as you said, Ed, but comes back strong on the next. Showed great composure.
Hunyak has 4 points tonight. We talked about Hunyak, Haynes, and Ketters. Ketters has 4 points. Hunyak has 4 points. Those guys have stepped up here in game six. Marinaro, he drilled it and hit Haynes. The race, Carbonero won it. Here he comes. He shot it in the seat. Now, the Crunch really having problems getting the ball on frame tonight. And when they have, Brett Phillips has been outstanding. Shaking his head is Bruce Miller.
See, the point leaders tonight, Deshantret, the guy we mentioned right at the beginning, you knew he was going to come out and play strong tonight. Always does. And Carmine, a bit of a surprise for Kansas City, the defender in the back, providing some offensive spark with 5 points.
Here comes Chris Hanser, who has the Crunch, one of the Crunch goals. Marinaro the other. Crunch will get a restart.
Usually see Cleveland try to change their personnel. That time they just left the 5 players who were on the field. Normally you'd see about 3 or 4 guys scrambling to the bench. You see them there. They'll get the personnel they want on for this restart.
So Kansas City put the ball down as quickly as possible so the time can start ticking. Carrots banged it into the wall. Now Carbonero will re-rack to the foot of Otto Orr. Checking two is Carriage. The Chantret is there. Carbonero. He's stopped by Hunyak and back for Tima. He missed everybody with the pass.
I tell you, Cleveland looks a little tired. I can't help but think a lot of that emotion in the pregame ceremonies that Mace told you about, the intensity. And now to Chantret. I thought he would start something in the first half just to get this crowd into it. Here he goes. And you'll see the crowd boo to Chantret from here on out, and that just inspires him even more.
It looks like Tima might be going out too.
See to Chantret come in from behind on Gutierrez, and then Tima is going to stick up for Henry, come in on Lee. And then Lee and Deshantret, who have seen each other over the years in this league, mix it up one more time.
Tima's going to head to the penalty box, too. And originally, it looked like the blue card was only shown to Deshantret. Both guys will go off. We're 2 minutes on sportsmanlike conduct, so we'll play 4-a-side.
Well, you see Tima still having words for Deshantret in the box. And he says, next time you get out there, Lee, I'm going to stick you one time.
Marinaro leaves it to the foot. Battle in the corner. Wade got it back for Phillips. Let's go down to Greg Mace. What's happening down there, Greg?
I'll tell you what, Leif Deschanterets showed a lot of maturity and poise there for Leif Deschanterets. Usually we'll see him screaming and yelling at the other guy. He banged his hands up against the board, almost in disgust at himself, thinking, why did I draw that penalty? Now he's in the box. What a great offensive game Leif's had, and I think he's keeping his emotions under control.
That's a big key for Kansas City.
It is, but you know, he's the kind of guy that loves to hear the boos. He loves the boos. And you know when he gets back out there, the crowd's going to be all over him, Ed. And it only inspires him to play harder. And Timo, a guy that's never going to back down from a challenge.
Marinaro shut down by Phillips there. Brett racing off of his line. He knows he had a good game tonight. It's Eddie Carman. Not only defensively, but offensively. This is Jason Farrell, first-year player. He's had some big goals. He found Wade. Hudnyak, he's been magic. Across, oh, big stop by Trakicevic, and he got lucky with the bounce.
That ball almost redirected off Oscar and into his own goal.
Phillips long.
Now Kansas City getting some good numbers opportunity in the attacking third. You see there, 2-on-2.
5 seconds left on the Miners. Here's another chance for Marinaro, I believe. No, this is for KC.
Kansas City will get numbers up. They need to finish their chances. For Gisevich, good cover at the back post. He was fortunate that ball went over the top.
You know, a little while ago you said it looks like Cleveland is a little bit slow, and I'm starting to get the same feeling. Miller, left footer, hit the post. Carbonara can't get on to that rebound. They just look a bit slower in closing down space. Here's John Ball marking Farrell, who hit a rocket. The rebound to space. Ball nipped in and got it for the crunch. Here's Doug Miller looking to get the crunch up to 5.
But look at the 4 blue jerseys back in defense. Cleveland with no one crashing in for the rebound. See our shots on goal favoring Cleveland, but the scoreboard favoring Kansas City as they lead by 9.
Both Kima and Deschanterets are out of the box now, and both are on the floor. We'll see if anything carries over. Kima now marking Carmine. Carmine has been deep in the offensive end for KC this entire game. He's got 5 points to show for it. He came into the series with 8 points in the playoffs. He's added 5 more. Double team. Deschanterets got it back to Wade. A step. Throws to the corner. And he is called by Glenn Carbonara and John Ball. Wade looking for the penalty. And there's your score.
Hudnyak at the back post. They got a 2-on-1 back there.
Deschanterets creeping in front of goal. Hudnyak's one-timer missed wide. Miller can't get around Wade. And Doug wins it back to Orr. Otto plays early. Schweitzer will catch up to it. Scott Schweitzer, second-year man, walked around to Hudnyak, then played back to Gisevic! Schweitzer takes it back in the center circle. Miller turns to face. They'll see Wade. No give and go there. Wade conveniently knocked down Miller on his way. Gutierrez will just play it back. Kansas City making it real tough for the crunch to find any openings in that defense.
We saw what Wade did with Miller on that 1-2 as he stayed with the runner on the 1-2 and not follow the ball. You get caught following the ball against this team and that runner is going to be open on the 1-2.
Gutierrez is called for a foul holding off Carmi. And Henry's been known to take a 5-minute misconduct or 2 in his time.
The crowd starting to become a little impatient here with 2 minutes to go in the first half. And Kansas City, as you see the fouls, has played a near perfect first half defensively.
That's what they built their team on. They gave up only 10.8 points per game during the regular season to lead the league. And the crunch averaged 19.9 a game scoring to lead the league in that category. So we came into the series as the league's best offense against the league's best defense. And right now, this game has the defense winning out. Kansas City has put it together.
Cleveland scored at least 17 points in all five games. And I asked Zoran Savic, can you hold this team under 15 points? And he said, we can. We got to play smarter. We can't give away silly fouls. We got to keep better possession of the ball.
Barrett with a step around Hauser. He scores!
Well, they had played near perfect defense until this point, because this is a soft goal that Kansas City gives up here with a minute four left. Watch again. Nothing fancy about this one, just the Z-man down the left side, and how this shot sneaks in there, I don't know, but it just somehow finds its way into the far post, and a big goal by Cleveland here to cut it to seven with just over a minute to go in the fourth.
That's got to make the 30-plus-year-olds proud. That Zoran Karic, 34 years old, going past Nate Hauser, 23 years old.
Well, a quick healer. You see what he's done in the five games, and the first three games, only three goals really come to life since that time.
And here he comes again. Played it into space. Tommy Tanner right side. He missed it wide. A little bit of fire under the boots of the crutch. Marinaro didn't get it off. Great ball from Carbonara.
Kansas City needs to be careful here. They don't want to give one more away.
The story in the upper left-hand corner of your screen. Carbonara just bullet his way through. And a foul called against Carbonara. DeChantret slowed things down.
Well, that last goal by Carrick scored from a very difficult angle. Don't know how that one sneaked by Phillips, as he had been outstanding up to that point.
Here come the crunch. Maybe a final attack before the half. They trail. There's a foul called against KC.
Well, Zoran trying to draw a shootout there, hoping the referee would pull him right in front of him. But Richard Heron said, come on, you got to do better than that, Z.
Otto thumps it. Hunyak got up to head it. Schweitzer being tugged at by Rogers. Jeff Rogers has had a few dances with a few of the crunch players tonight. Otto will go long. Ketters won that. Z settles that. He's tripped up along the boards by Limniotis.
Well, Kansas City very fortunate to get out of this half without a blue card. Cleveland might think about a timeout here to set something up on the restart.
Miller was trying to get on for sixth attacker, never did. And there's the horn. We're at halftime. An 8-point run for Kansas City from the mid portion of the first quarter into the second quarter. Built the lead, and Greg Mays has Zoran Savic down on the floor.
Ready? Yeah, go ahead. Zoran, let's talk a little bit about the first half. Up until that last couple moments there, you seem like you put on a textbook clinic. Give me a read.
Well, we wanted to come in here and play tight defense, not give Zoran and Hector so much room, and I think we've been successful until that last play.
And you know how quickly they can strike. What do you have to do now defensively in the second half?
Nothing different that we've been doing, and look for us to do the same thing that we've been doing in the first half. We've got to be tight, we've got to be composed, and I give him a lot of room. Think of our chances.
All right, Zoran, thank you. Off to the locker room. Zoran Savic, back to Ed.
All right, thanks a lot, Greg. It is halftime in game six. Kansas City ahead by seven. Halftime continues here at the CSU Convocation Center, where the Kansas City Attack has a 7-5 lead over the Cleveland Crunch. You know, I know I've said it a few times during the season when we've seen Kansas City play, Art, and that is that the Attack always seem to execute and be perfect when they need to do it, and they've done that tonight.
Well, both times that Cleveland scored in this game, Kansas City has come back and scored on the very next shift. They've also scored at the beginning of each quarter. Lee DeChantret really providing the offensive spark for Kansas City. And this goal, just 41 seconds into the game, got him started. Typical DeChantret work, just working hard in the box, and heads one over Orff to get Kansas City started. And then in the second quarter, he does the very same thing. He comes out and gets Kansas City a goal in the first minute of the second quarter.
And this time he just beats Orff to the near side, but to Chantret, a guy that loves these situations with the big crowd, loves to play that part of the village.
Well, you called it, Art, no doubt about it. Now let's head down to the locker room area and visit with Greg Mace for some atmosphere. Greg, what's going on down there?
Well, the Kansas City locker room door is shut airtight. We've been in this hallway many, many times just before the start of halves. Right now you can hear a pin drop in here. There is a lot of tension on the part of both teams. We asked to talk to somebody from the Kansas City Attack. Zoran said, listen, I got to keep talking to these guys, no way. Same deal with the Cleveland Crunch. There was a terrific pregame atmosphere here, unlike we've ever seen, and the atmosphere here in the hallway between the halves is also unlike we've never seen before.
All right, Greg, thanks a lot. Here's some statistics from the first half of play, and I guess the one that jumps out at you are the saves.
Yeah, the saves. 13 saves for Brett Phillips, only 4 for Otto Orff. But the restart goals, Cleveland 1-for-11. You can't give those guys too many restarts. They'll make you pay.
Well, the Kansas City Attack is going on a run. Let's see if the Crunch has a run in them in the second half. We'll see as we head to break. Sinek and Art Kramer back at the Cleveland State University Convocation Center. The Kansas City Attack trying to extend this series to a 7th and deciding game.
And they're trying to do what no other team in this league has been able to do in the playoffs, and that's win here in Cleveland. The Crunch 6-0, the Attack 5-0 when they lead at halftime.
Kansas City in blue moving left to right. Eddie Carmine has a goal and 3 assists. Ketters has a goal tonight. Livniadis, part of the defense, they'll react, re-rack to Brett Phillips, who's made some unbelievable saves. A couple on Tommy Tanner. One on Doug Miller, I can remember. Along the boards, the whistle blows, and I didn't see the rest point in direction. Now Richard Herron is saying, we're going this way, boys.
Well, this first 5 minutes is very important for Cleveland, Ed, and they don't lose their defensive shape. They can't become undisciplined and try to score all these points right now to start the third quarter, because if they do, they're going to give a lot of space in their backfield.
There's Jason Farrell. Had 22 points during the regular season. 19 in the playoffs. Just getting better and better, and we've talked about it a few times. DeShantra tries one. And he's coming up limping. I think he collided knees, maybe. Boy, he went quickly after that ball when he needed to, though.
He went from limping to a dead sprint.
Ran into Schweitzer. Carries on. Has trouble with that one. Zoran turns it up a gear. Carriage coming forward against Hauser with speed. Tries a three-pointer. Missed it high. Farrell had one bang off. This is Tanner along the boards. Ball spinning away, and I think they're going to call a handball.
You see the point leaders tonight, DeChantret 6, Carriage with 4. But also Eddie Carmine, a defender for Kansas City, with 5 points on a goal and 3 assists.
Marinaro! We didn't get that one on frame.
Cleveland now 1-for-12. On the evening, on their restarts.
Hector has had a couple of magical games here at CSU in the playoffs. 2 10-pointers in games 3 and 4. That's not easy being a forward with the talent of Zoran Karic.
In the 2 games that Kansas City won, they held Marinaro to just a goal and an assist in the second half. In the other 3 games, he went crazy when the game was on the line.
Carriage will restart. Played it off the wall. And a foul called against Goran Hunyak, who had to slow him down. Goran and Zoran having a few words. G will try it again. He has been unable to get it to Hector, other than that 1-point power play goal. He's open. The right footer. He's gone!
Well, a
very last second to loop his run around to the three-point arc. And you said they've been having trouble connecting, but that time they connect perfectly. You see Dragicevic with the first run. Hector loops his run around and then puts it right through Ketters' legs. And Phillips never even saw that shot, Ed. And quickly, Cleveland brings it within five.
3 points for Marinaro, upping his playoff total to 97. Zoran Karic has himself three assists and a point. There's the numbers. Asterisks near all of them.
Well, Hector, the predominant goal scorer in the league in the last 4 years.
Eddie Carmi. Now Tanner leaves it for Carriage. Zoran will cut it into space, tries to catch up with Carmi, recovered and made the slide tackle. Dangerous ball from Farrell. Marinaro can't get it. On goal. Oh, Eddie, or adjacent Farrell.
We mentioned just before that both times that Kansas City, that Cleveland has scored, Kansas City came back the next shift to score. And you see right here, Cleveland almost makes Kansas City pay, but Phillips with some good work in front.
There were two guys in front of Brett Phillips, not just one. Jason Farrell really got away with it there. Steal from Ketters. He's moving ahead. Kicked out by Orff. And Carbonaro loops it. Hanser will try to hold off Wade. Good work there. He whacked that one ahead. Rogers is tracking Doug Miller. Pima just knocked Haynes down and Tom Landy blew the whistle. Ryan Haynes had 6 points in game five of the National Division Finals against St. Louis. Let's watch Otto.
Well, Otto has played strong all series. You get a good idea what he's looking at as Ketters comes down that left side. Otto kicks out that left leg.
29 wins during the regular season. He's 8-3 in the playoffs with a points against of 15.75. West Wade. Ryan Lofton tries to spin out of a Malachi crunch. Can't do it. Now a race. Wade will win it. And turn it back upfield.
And every time you say a race and Wade's in it, he seems to win it.
They don't call him lightning for nothing. And I think he's even a little bit faster because he actually got a haircut. A giveaway. Is back.
That ball was on Miller's off foot. He's a left-sided player, struggled a little bit that time with it on his right foot. But now Kansas City had with a careless play on the over and back, but no call. Maybe that pass was deflected.
KC has been fortunate to keep this 5-point lead after some of the giveaways they had made here in the early portions of the third quarter. We're talking about Westway. He had some big hair working during the regular season. It's still long, but it's not as hardly Ryan-ish as it was. The chance at working again. Punch with some nice touches to get out of that. Gutierrez. Carbonara. Miller. Can't get past Wade, but the over and back will give the ball to the crunch.
In the midst of a 4-0 run of their own here, and they're going to look to add to that on this restart.
Played Marinaro, Hector! And get blocked. It's blocked into the fence by Hauser. Kansas City really doing well, making that transition both offensively and defensively. Here comes Waitrell in the play. Three-pointer missed it wide. Ketters can't control the hard rebound. Tanner and Rogers after it. Look out, trouble!
For Kansas City and a great block by Tima, the old veteran for Cleveland.
Listen to the crowd.
And watch Tima again, standing strong on his line, takes that one off the face for his team.
Carriage holding off they'll slow it down. Schweitzer made the tackle, and the Crunch will attack.
Kansas City very careful to only attack with no more than three players. They don't want to give up that two-on-one counter the other way.
Side Rodgers won the race to the rebound. Kansas City was a right by that time they give it away. Wade is in trouble and got it around Marinero. Petters knocked down by Janisevic.
That's what experienced players will do. They'll get you along the boards and feel for the contact. And when they do, they'll take a dive and get that call. And you see the hero just a minute ago, Tim Tima.
He got hit in the face by Otto, not only there, but by Otto Orff in game five.
Tima suffered a slight concussion in game five and was out for a quarter and then came back to finish that game.
Armin got tripped up, he's feeling the effects of that one.
Really a pivotal point in this game now, Ed. Kansas City can get the next goal, they'd be up by seven, but Cleveland looking to close to within three.
Hunyak, Petters, Army, blocked by Janisevic. Oscar came into the game leading the Crunch and the league in blocks during the playoffs with 27. Hunyak again.
You see Kansas City going to be very patient. Try to play with a lot of discipline offensively.
Played the boards, Trakisevic tracking. Mishantek couldn't get it through the legs. And the Cowboy tries to come out. Merritt says foul. Beat Mishantek. Mishantek with a hat trick. He has the attack ahead. Art Kramer back at CSU. Crunch leading this best of seven, 3-2, but it's Kansas City fighting for their playoff lives. Over and back called against the Crunch.
Kansas City came into this half with a 12-5 lead. I tell you, 12 points is not going to be enough to win this game. They're going to need to score some more points to beat Cleveland in this building.
Lofton shoots it just over the bar, and it's helped out by Karic after the loose ball. Carmine poked it ahead. It's going to roll to Orff. It's going to look long. See what the Crunch does with this. They're going 2-on-4. Karic shot it just wide. Oh, that was a lot more dangerous than it looked when it started.
Well, Marinero in front providing a screen as well.
Hector looking for some help. Pulling through his Tanner.
That left foot this time, and Karic right in front of Phillips.
Cleveland Crunch looking to get this big crowd into the game. Actually, outside of that goal by Marinero, that one defensive stand where they got some saves and a big save by Tima, his biggest rise. Left footed ahead. It's a joy to watch Hunyak play. There's a steal by Carbonero. Marinero moving in against the double team play. The boards. Gutierrez. Phillips again. Gutierrez. Phillips again. And they miss wide. Oh. And the stop is made.
Oh, Henry. Gutierrez with three straight chances. And Phillips with two good saves, and he missed the third one wide.
Oh,
Gutierrez upset on the bench, but what's the good run by Henry? But Phillips with a reaction save, and then another one, and the third one just wide.
Tanner out of a crowd. He lost it again. Early ball. Wade will bust that up. A little too light on the pass. Oh, man. Oh, man. The collision's getting harder and rougher. And Brian Lofton felt Zoran Karic going after a loose ball.
Watch again, Lofton getting drilled by Karic, but Lofton staying down, trying to buy a little time for his team. I think he senses the momentum is really starting to turn Cleveland's way.
Schweitzer, fouled by Rogers. The referees have been very consistent in making those calls right away. Rogers can't believe it.
Well, one of the keys for Kansas City is not to give away fouls down here in this third of the field.
Kansas City defenders also have been very good at stepping in front of target players to deny the ball. Dumped in. White took a touch.
Bruce Miller, the coach of Cleveland, has said many times, if we can hold Kansas City to 12 points or less, we'll win the game.
Haynes from a bad spot. Rockets it on goal. Jim Schwab on the floor for KC. Carmine spun away from Marinaro. Strong work to possess, and Hanser takes it away. Early ball, Marinaro in the corner. Carmine, Hanser trailing. There's a back at Bessie, shoots. Missed it wide, and Phillips scrambles.
Well, once again, Brett Phillips coming up big in the Kansas City net.
Mason Farrell shot blocked off of Gutierrez. It'll be a free kick for Kansas City. It's game six. Chris Hanser has a goal for the Crunch. Cleveland has come up short.
Look at the nifty little back heel that time by Marinaro. And Hanser, who already has one goal, looking for his second one.
Hunyak drilled it. Marinaro busted it up. There's a two-on-one. Ketters tried to feed to Shantrick. Now a race. Lee will win it there. Schweitzer stepped in and fouled him. And Lee will go for a break. Cleveland is going to have to be very wary of the fact that they've had opportunities here and they're going forward. A lot of times when you don't cash in on them, you pay for it later on. You get all that momentum carrying you forward. And it's hard to remember, you got to do it on the other side as well. Heritage, marked by who else? Eddie Carmine. Tries to backheel, bust it up. Gutierrez had to stretch to take that.
A little surprised Zoran didn't try to deal one-on-one that time as Kansas City was a little late coming with the double team.
Gutierrez in the corner with Ketters on him. Tima at the line. Walk by, volleys it! Just over the bar. Carbonara, back drawer.
Cleveland needs a little bit better movement off the ball when they play it into the target man. As three players are standing outside their own yellow line, watching that target player stand on the ball, you need to run off of him.
Wade couldn't get it back to Phillips the first time. Now we'll clear it along the boards. Lucky that ball stayed in bounds. Otto will move forward again as Kansas City's defense digs in back behind the half line. A foul called against Wes Wade.
Kansas City looks as if they've gotten into this prevent defense, and I've said many times, the prevent defense does one thing, it prevents you from winning. They need more points against Cleveland. 12 will not be enough here.
Carriage for Tima. Back for catch. His left foot hit the hose. And he's got his hands on his head and disbelief.
Well, we saw Hector hit a ball off both posts back in game four.
Gutierrez. Some neat work. Tima in for Carriage. He tries to spin on Rogers. The foul call.
Well, had Zoran waited just another half second, he had Gutierrez making a nice run off the ball for him. Take a look, you see Henry coming around, but Z draws the foul as Rogers took him down there. Dangerous opportunity now for Cleveland.
Marinaro left, Carbonara right. Gutierrez and team at the posts. There's the three-man wall. Carriage Hunyak's at the controls.
Hector likes to toe poke him.
He shoots. Phillips made the stop. And Hunyak cleared it back to the crunch yellow line. Here's Carriage, long range, punched out by Phillips. Dima got a head on it, it's out of play.
Phillips unable to catch that ball because that shot was dipping as Zorin hit it right on the screws. With no spin, that ball was knuckling. Take another look, you see that ball dip and Marinaro providing a screen in front.
There's only been 2 points scored in this quarter. Scored by Hector Marinaro. At the 2:02 mark, we've gone about 10 minutes or so without a point. Dragicevic in a corner, the Cowboy. Hanser holds off Farrell, plays Miller. Coming in against Wade. Through the legs, Hanser chasing it down. Double team help from Wade. Kansas City has been so strong.
Instincts are as a forward. He's done an admirable job back in the back replacing their captain Schwab.
Haynes carries on. Continued to be hounded.
Scotty!
By Carbonera. Hauser, strong work.
I've been impressed all night long at the way Kansas City has shielded the ball in tight spaces.
Schweitzer wins. Oh, that was Dugisic that won that battle with Cassandra. But not without feeling it. Look at how far back Carriage is coming to get the ball now. Gave it away. Wade will take him on. Wes Wade. Knocked down by Carriage in the foul call.
Well, Wade, we've seen that a number of times for both teams. The players just feeling that contact and then going down to draw the restarts. And Wade with a quick burst to his right, and Zorin comes in. Looks West there.
Little role reversal on that particular scene. Carriage is usually the one being taken down. Ketters faces a two-man wall. He drills it off the wall. Hauser after it. Schweitzer wagging away in front of the goal. Gutierrez nipped it away momentarily. But Wade carries on. West Wade has had a strong game. And he draws the foul again. Bell restarted back where Wade was taken down. West looking for the 15 feet.
West trying to buy all the time he can here.
28 years old, and Ketters hit it. Got a goal by loose ball.
Well, Ketters has had about 10 or 11 shots in the last three games, and they've all been right at Otto Orff.
Marinaro, Dodgers posted, looped it over Carriage. There's the time for the third quarter. Zorin is saying it deflected off of an Attack player. He's not going to get that call. The faces of the crunch, now the Attack. Bruce Miller, Hector Marinaro, Otto Orff. Everybody in Cleveland was ready to party, but the Kansas City Attack coming into this game. Third of four quarters winding down.
And Phillips has played outstanding in the goal for Kansas City, and he's one of the big reasons why Kansas City owned this 5-point lead, but not a safe lead, Ed, I'm telling you. This Cleveland team could score points in a hurry.
Marinaro looped it for Gutierrez. Couldn't get over it. Henry had to readjust his run just a little bit, and that allowed enough time for the ball to hop up higher than he wanted it to.
People may think this is a great quarter for Kansas City. They got out of here, and they're still five up, but I tell you, it was a great quarter for Cleveland in the fact that they've stayed in this game. If they get in the crowd into it in the fourth quarter, look out.
19 saves for Brett Phillips. Rookie of the year a few seasons back, and he has stood tall in goal for Kansas City. Cleveland Crunch have some very impressive drapes hanging from the ceiling. The divisional playoff champs, 93, 94, 94, 95. But the one they want is the big, huge one in the middle, the championship banner that they won back in 1994. Let's go down to Greg Mace and see what Bruce Miller has for his guys going to the fourth quarter.
All right, and here's what Bruce Miller had to say. Let's get 5 points in the next 10 minutes, and then we will take control of the game. And then at least we'll be in a position to tie it up and then go on to win it. Obviously, they have held Kansas City defensively here. Now he said, let's make it real simple. 5 points, 10 minutes, go after it. Ed?
And it's a big crowd here, 12,509 in the CSU Convocation Center. It's an all-time NPSL playoff record, but they want to do a lot more cheering than they have been to this point. Their team trails it by five.
Well, Hector said in this morning's Plain Dealer that the crowd has been their seventh man all season long, and this is where they really need them. This is where Hector Marinaro usually steps up and provides the heroics.
He dumps it in Gutierrez. What a job he did to take that down. Schweitzer following, or that's Dragicevic following up the play into Karic. He has some space. Let's see what he does with it. It's kicked out by Phillips again.
What a job by Phillips to cut down the angle that time. Take that shot off his knees.
Dragicevic ran into Haynes. Look out. Kansas City coming for 2-on-1. Haynes and Ketters. A pass behind Ketters. Dragicevic turned it upfield. Now a race to the ball. Marinaro will win it. He played it hard off the boards. Karic will take it there. Got it out of trouble. Schweitzer takes advantage of the space. In the corner, Marinaro. Carmine is on him. Tried to turn it. Phillips helped out.
Good defensive work by Carmine that time from Kansas City. And I'm sure you'll see a lot of floor time for Marinaro and Karic here in the fourth quarter.
Dragicevic holding off a tenacious Jeff Rogers. Rogers finally won the ball. Good work from Rogers. And backtracking from Tanner, won the ball for Cleveland. Kansas City needs a win to force it back to Kemper Arena.
We saw Otto score a three-point earlier in this season, or earlier in this series, and here he comes forward again.
I'll leave it for Karic this time. Zorn shoots it headed out by Brian Lofton, and then Lumniatis will clear it to the crunch end.
Kansas City now going to play a low-pressure defense. They're going to drop back all the way back in their own half of the field.
Marinaro working in front of goal. Turned and kicked out. Loose ball. Lumniatis.
Well, Phillips once again. The nice save on that shot to the far post.
Richard Herron saw Jeff Rogers tug on his jersey. And Tim Tebow's going to sit for two. Ah, Jeff Rogers did a great job of drawing that one.
Referee always sees the retaliation. Tima saying Rogers had come up high with the elbow, but it was the retaliation that the referee saw. Take a look at the initial challenge here as Rogers and Tima both going at it. See Rogers tugging on Tima, and then both of them shoulder to shoulder. Tima, that's where he gets called right there.
Tima will sit in the box for the second time tonight. Already told you he's won 4 championships in his career. 13-year vet from the Cleveland area. He hasn't lost any fire, that's for sure.
It's not a penalty that Cleveland wanted to take here. He'll be short-handed now for the next 2 minutes.
Tom Landy having a word with Jim Adams. Down to Greg Mace.
Well, Tim Team is obviously very frustrated after that penalty, and they're going at it here tooth and nail. It's getting awfully chippy now at this point, and that's not where you want to start drawing penalties, and that's what just happened to number 17, Tim Tima.
Crunch will play with 4 players for the next 2 minutes against 5 for Kansas City. You saw the numbers there for both the KC power play and the Crunch penalty killing unit. Crunch still can score 2 and 3 point goals here. Kansas City can only score a one pointer.
And what's important as well for Kansas City is they can run a full 2 minutes off the clock here on their man advantage. Team is still hot in the box. There's a good point Greg Mace makes, and that you need to keep your composure in pressure situations. Tima, a guy that's been there before, he should know that.
Well, you saw Tima turning to his left. He was getting talked to by Bruce Miller, the Crunch coach.
And Tima, the player assistant coach.
In addition to those championships, Tima's been a three-time Defender of the Year. He's seen a lot in this league, making many a bus and van ride. I'll leave you a few stories if you got the time.
And you see now Kansas City can afford to be patient here and run some clock. They don't necessarily need to go forward and score in this first minute on the power play. And with two veteran players like Wade and Petters out on top, I think you'll see them run a little bit of clock if they can.
They're going to say that ball deflected off of a Crunch player, so Kansas City will have a free kick out high on the right side. Richard Herron, veteran official. Tom Landy as well. Restart again. Wade. Eddie Carmi moving ahead. Kunyak got it to nobody, and Todd Lisoski will knock it over three lines, so that means they'll bring it all the way back to the Crunch end again.
Kansas City now with Cleveland with the man down has a real nice opportunity on this restart. Is with four defenders, you can only cover so much ground. And Haynes is on Wade's right and Ketter's on his left.
Couple of fakes, curled it, and Otto saw it. Stacking.
Well, Wes used that same restart successfully in game three, but Cleveland wasn't biting on it that time, and now Otto throws the ball out of play. Cardinal sin for a goalkeeper because it comes all the way back the other way, Ed, and Kansas City now with their third straight restart opportunity.
Facing two-man wall. Three guys, Roman free for KC. Ryan Haynes leaves it for Ketters, right footer, Schweitzer got out, blocked it, it's going out, that's corner kick material for Kansas City.
Good play that time by Schweitzer to read the little back heel from Haynes. He stepped out and blocked it. Yatima still 50 seconds left in that penalty.
Wait again. Couple of fakes. Wait for something. Hunyak under the crossbar. And the Crunch get the bounce.
Oh, how did that one stay out? As Hunyak drilled one off the underside of the bar. And I was waiting for the red light to come on that one.
You and me both, partner. Crunch now possess a little while. And while the Crunch have the ball, they'll get Marinaro and Carriage off the bench. Carriage volley! And out of play. Here's Hunyak again, unlucky.
See the restart, the little lane right through the middle, and then Gorin takes a bouncing ball, and lucky for Otto Orff, that ball didn't hit off the back. And you see tonight's hero, Lee Tschentret, making sure he gets in front of Otto Orff and not allow that long outlet because he had Carriage down at the other end of the floor.
Wade coming forward with 20 seconds to go on the man advantage. A race for the ball. Hey, a race for the ball. Wes Wade.
That's the great thing that I really like about Tschentret is he never stops working regardless of the situation. Most players, when Orff had that ball in their hands, would have stopped playing, but you saw Lee still working, trying to get in front of Otto and deny that outlet. Kansas City didn't score on their power play, but they have successfully worked down the full 2 minutes.
Tima is out on the floor, and the play should pick up a bit. Kansas City turns it up. Loose ball to Tschentret. Keeps possession. with Todd Dasaski at him. Hunyak turned it the other direction. Dasaski found a teammate in Doug Miller. He splits a pair. Here he comes. Miller running one on two, looking for help. Nobody there right now. He's shot. It got blocked. Carry on was Miller. A curl along the boards.
Well, Miller almost made something happen, one against two and then one against three. But Cleveland's supporting players a little bit slow to get forward and help Miller.
Otto. Marinaro in the corner. Ketters will get it back easily. Well, the goal for Cleveland was to get 5 points in 10 minutes. We're about 5 minutes into that. Good play by Orr. Just turning his body to shield off Rodgers. Kansas City, very confident that they can beat the Crunch here.
Still say that next goal, though, Ed, is going to be the big one.
Jason,
5-point lead is not safe against this Cleveland team.
Jason Farrell had his arm around Gutierrez. He took him down. This is dangerous waters for Kansas City. Trgicevic out high, Marinaro a few feet away. Hector should have scored! For Marinaro.
And you see four blue jerseys in front of Phillips, and I don't think Phillips ever even saw that shot. Hector, just one time.
Is that the start of a run? Scott Schweitzer helping out this crowd of over 12,000. The Crunch has gotten to within three.
And an important shift now for Kansas City.
Play on. Gutierrez. Carriage. The give and go busted up.
And nobody's sitting down here.
Marinaro shot blocked by Haynes. Well, in the 1994 championships against St. Louis, that game went to double overtime, and nobody in the place sat down for two quarters. Over and back called against the Crunch.
Now Kansas City's going to have a chance on a restart. And Haynes is the man that's going to put it in play. He's got that big left foot.
Here's Haynes.
And the referee is blowing the whistle, Ed, but the players can't hear him because of the crowd.
So a restart, and you see Brian Haynes working on Chris Hanser.
I tell you, Kansas City has been stuck at 12 here in the second half.
Haynes for Lofton. Tonight, that time missed it wide. Miller ran into by Limbiotis, and the Crunch will get the ball back.
And Carmine had Rodgers at the far post, didn't see him.
Kansas City hasn't scored a point in 27 minutes. Jim Schwab stepping on the field for Kansas City, and a timeout. Now we got a blue card, huh?
There may be too many men on the field once again for Kansas City. Because that penalty door is open just next to the Kansas City bench.
Bruce Miller in thought. You saw Marinaro egging on the crowd. Jim Schwab in for another penalty-killing shift. The Crunch scored a power play goal from Hector Marinaro.
That we didn't get the call on the penalty, but I believe it may have been too many men on the floor. The third time in the last two games that Kansas City has been called for this penalty.
The Crunch with a goal can get within 2 points. Listen to the crowd.
City probably didn't get caught for that penalty more than three times the whole season. Yep. And it's happened to him three times in the last two games.
Eastman and Marinero play a little catch. They slide it in the carriage. Here's Gutierrez in front. Big stop by Limniotis. And he comes up limping out of that one. Phillips will look long. Deshantra just off the bench. Nice collection. Marinero stepped in. Played it forward. Carriage moving it against Schwab. Let's see if he takes him on to his left. Now his right again. Stepping in to help was Ketters. Here comes Dragicic in front. Stopped by Phillips again and again.
Wow. Give Schwab credit defensively for Kansas City. He's got that wide body, and Carriage just couldn't find his way around Jimmy.
Ryan Lofton serving this penalty for KC. There's 52 seconds left on the power play. Right in front of goal.
You see Schwab with that heavily taped left hamstring. That's a big hamstring.
Marinero with Schwab on him, and Schwab stepped in. The ref save play on. Hector looking for something. Ain't going to get it.
Well, I said, Jimmy, with that wide body, there's no getting around him. That's what makes him one of the top defenders in the league.
He'll waste some time by knocking it along the boards. We're halfway through the fourth quarter.
And we got 24 seconds left in this power play for Cleveland.
Marinero for Gutierrez. A look from the end zone. Chris Hanser now is out in the middle of this power play unit instead of Carriage. Crunch playing keep away. They play far close. Hanser after it. Hit the boards. Here's Dragicevic. Phillips with the answer.
Both teams at full strength, and now Lofton out of the box.
He's got pace. He shot it out. The Crunch will get the ball. Kansas City kills off that power play. And they hang on to a three-point lead. Carriage shaken up. That's why Hanser was out there. I don't know if it was his knee or maybe his thigh, it looked like he was favoring.
That's a big penalty killing that time by Kansas City.
Tima over and back. Nice play by Tim Tima. Moving down to Greg Mace. What's up with Zorin?
All right, looks like he's pulled his thigh muscle, and he has. He's trying to stretch it out. We can take a look right down here. Zorin is actually off here on the sideline, trying to stretch it out. It's been a problem all year. He's got to get back in this game.
Well, he's got to get back because he's the man that makes it happen on the restarts.
Hector missed wide. He can't touch that ball unless he wants the whistle to blow good work by his teammates. A steal by Hunyak. Ketters can't get him the ball back. It's over and back on the Crunch.
Carbonera not happy with that. He felt the ball was already on his own third of the field, but Kansas City's going to have a restart.
Zorin still working out the pain. Wade with a couple of fakes to pass behind Carmine. They'll re-rack to Phillips. Brett Phillips, Eddie Carmine, John Limniotis, Wes Wade. They've done the job defensively. There's the touch. Carmine shoots, blocked by Miller at the defense. And a foul against Carmine.
That's one thing that Cleveland has had in the last four games they didn't have in the first two games is their forwards playing good defense. You saw Miller back there blocking that shot in front of Otto.
Tanner in a race. Foul against Wes Wade. He can't believe it.
You cannot give these guys restarts. Zorin Carriage back on the floor.
He came limping out
to trigger this restart.
Rich Herron telling him not to move the ball.
The last one went to Hector. Just a little touch pass.
Schweitzer is beyond the three-point line. Just out of your picture there a moment ago. See? Couldn't get it through the wall, and Schweitzer will try to beat Lofton there. He did. Got it to Marinaro. Now Karras just over the bar. Schweitzer took it down. Hunyuk stepped in. Scott bought himself some time. He's got 2 3-pointers in the series. Karras shoots the goal!
On a 6-0 run.
Great ball from Wade. Schweitzer beat Hunyuk there. Here comes Schweitzer. Karras got it for Marinaro. He'll move in on Carmine. Ah, he missed Gutierrez with the pass in. First and goal. Collins. Big tackle by Gordon Hunyak, that linebacker.
Well, Kansas City is going to need their experienced players to really step up right now. Hunyak to Shantrek, Ketters, Wade, and Haynes are their guys that have a lot of experience, and they need to close it out here, the final 4:21.
There's a lot of time left in this contest. The Crunch was down 12-3 at one point. Kansas City hasn't scored since the first half. Gisevich got it off the boards. Carmine won the race. Gisevich followed up. They'll tangle there. Who'll come out? The Crunch for Gisevich in front, kicked out by Phillips. The ball will stay in. Parrots, Boise, Liberty. A lot of guys playing with some pain.
You see Orff all the way out by the yellow line. He has not had anything to do here in the second half, as it's been all Cleveland. Kansas City content to sit on 12 points.
Marinaro, play the boards. Goodyear score! By Jeff Rogers. Casey breaks out. Wade. Carmine is open at the back stick. Here comes Lofton. Orff with the stop. The ball free.
Oh!
And blocked by Marinaro. Haynes. Dragicevich. And a foul call against Kansas City. Obstruction.
Oh, what saves by Otto Orff. As he hasn't had a lot to do this half, but he comes up big when needed.
Kick Santa Claus to get a uniform on.
Once again, Haynes, that shot blocked.
Haynes just knocked Tanner off the
foul,
ball.
But before that, there was about three or four fine stops by Otto and his defense. And I think next time Kansas City gets possession, they're going to try to get a timeout. Next dead ball and get that sixth attacker on. Yeah. Cleveland, on the other hand, that'll try to keep possession of ball along the boards and kill some clock.
Will it be another championship for the Crunch, or will it be a game seven in Kansas City?
And they are not going to take their timeout just yet. A little surprising, they had trouble getting a timeout in game five.
Wade, Ketters, Hunyak, Kishantra tried a give and go off the boards. Goodyear has cleared it out. Now, at this stage of the game, every pass becomes important. Hauser took down Marinero.
Well, they didn't take their sixth attacker when they had a chance at 2 minutes, 11 seconds. Now we're down to a minute 47.
Kansas City looking for a timeout.
But they can't take a timeout. They cannot take a timeout till they gain possession of the ball. And that's the problem. Cleveland has possession.
And back, they have to get it on the goalkeeper's foot.
And watch Cleveland. They're going to try to just keep possession of the ball the whole way.
Hauser ran into Marinero. They've got numbers. Schweitzer stepped in.
And now we're down to under a minute 25.
Ketters can't get it past Carbonero. That was a big stop because Hunyak was all by himself.
And now they're going to have a minute and 19 seconds to work with the sixth attacker. Oh, and they've given that restart to Cleveland. It looked like it was Kansas City's ball.
Kansas City's got to get the ball back from their own penalty area to their keeper.
Or if the ball were to go over the glass in their possession, they can also take a timeout.
Marinero got it to Schweitzer. Now Hunyak stepped in. Now a timeout will be called. Zoran Savic has a minute 13 to try and extend this series. Bruce Miller a minute 13 away from a championship in his rookie season as coach. We'll be back for the final minute 13 of game six.
12 points, not it.
Oh my! The Crunch can win a championship if they keep the Kansas City Attack off the score sheet for the next minute 13. Wes Wade is on as the sixth attacker. Crunch trying to bottle in the attack. Ketter's got it upfield and a two-on-one created. Deshantra and Carbonero took it off of his foot. Glenn Carbonero has made a couple of big defensive plays. Miller got a foot on it, but it got knocked out by Ketters. Wade has been a sixth attacker a few times in this series. Doug Miller. Will it?
Empty net goal here would ice it for the Crunch as this crowd is ready to explode. Here in Cleveland.
Herridge. Farrell ran into him and took it away. Hunyak. Numbers for KC. The ball played into space. Schweitzer got it upfield. Herridge in a race with Farrell. Tripped up. The whistle blows.
Now you're not going to see any blue cards coming out at this time. But Cleveland with possession of the ball. 37 left.
Remember, a two-point goal for KC puts them in the lead. So the Crunch not only has to hold on to this lead, they get scored upon. There's Kevin. He scores! A three-point goal for Zoran Karic. The bus is starting.
Point on this one with a three-point goal as he just chips it over the outstretched arms of Wes Wade.
It's a 13-point run for the Crunch. How many times have we heard that? 11 points for Zoran Karic. Andy Schmetzer there, world champions in 93-94. They may be adding another banner.
And for Zoran Savic and Kansas City side, they can only wonder what might have been.
Looks like the Crunch will add another title. 2 years ago to the day, they won their first. Now Bruce Miller can smile.
Well, Bruce Miller, only the second coach in his first season to win a title. The other one, the guy he's coaching against today, Zoran Savic. And give Savic and his Kansas City troops a great hand for the job they've done this season.
Well, we're trying to finish off this game, but the crowd here at the Convocation Center is littering the floor a bit prematurely. There's still 25 seconds left in this contest. Kansas City Attack had an 18-game winning streak during the regular season. They had an 8-game winning streak to end the regular season. The most games they lost consecutively was 2. Here in the playoffs, in the championship series, they have lost 4 straight.
Well, they'll be dancing in the suburbs tonight in Cleveland, and Hector starting to lead those dances already.
Wade rips it out of play. It'll be a restart for the Crunch outside the yellow line. Brett Phillips so close to a championship.
Well, Phillips disappointed, but certainly shouldn't be discouraged.
I'll write it down in the record books in Cleveland sports history. The Cleveland Indians also looking for a championship this year. If they could ever restart this game, you'll see streamers and balloons and every kind of party favor you can imagine.
Well, the two teams that really deserved to be here gave us a great show in the 6 games they played.
Finally restart, the clock is going. Tishantrit will drill it down. Dragicevic hangs on to it. The Cleveland Crunch are champs! smile. The look of wonderment and disappointment. And you see Cleveland trying to build a dynasty here in the NPSL. The second title in the last three seasons, the third time they've been there in the last 4 years. In their minds, a bit of revenge. They lost the 1993 title to the Kansas City Attack. They won it in 94, never got a chance to get to the title game last year. The Harrisburg Heat knocking them off in four games. On the start of the season, they set out to get what they felt was theirs.
Well, that's what they play for, that and the ring that they'll get to start the next season. And from George Hoffman, their owner, Al Miller, their GM, and Bruce Miller, their coach, and all the players, a great job by the Cleveland Crunch in 1996.
They go through the playoffs undefeated at home. A 7-0 record. They beat the Buffalo Blizzard 2-1 in the division semifinals. Took care of the Baltimore Spirit 3-1 in the divisional finals. And then came back from down 0-2 in the finals. A kiss from his wife Marty.
Well, Ed, it's party time tonight in Cleveland.
These moments are always hard to deal with on the losing end. I mean, what a fabulous season the Kansas City Attack had.
Well, especially the last 10 games of the regular season when they went on a 9-1 run to overtake Cleveland for the best record in the league. But it was that pivotal game five where Cleveland knocked off Kansas City in Kemper Arena that was really the turning point in this series.
An NPSL playoff record crowd enjoying the championship.
And Tima with his fifth one, he's got a ring for every finger, one for the thumb for Tima. People in the truck and the cameraman to provide you with some great shots here of this exciting finish in Cleveland.
There it is, officially your 1996 NPSL champs. Well, slip out and you'll get a whole lot of post-game coming your way, interviews, the trophy presentation, and a game recap after this.
Which way do you want it?
That one, the shots are going out of sight.
Just a minute. Your fine this way. Just face those cameras. These are our two, yes. No, we're right there. You're right. You're fine. You're fine. You're good. You're good, Steve. Don't look this. Look that. No, do it for me.
Do it for me, too. Do it for cameras. And here?
Do it for cameras. They're looking for Hoffman. They're looking for Hoffman. Here he comes. We're ready.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like first to congratulate the Kansas City Attack for giving us a tremendous championship final series. And now, On behalf of the NPSL, it's my pleasure to present the 1996 Championship Trophy to honor George Hoffman, Coach Bruce Miller, co-captains Andy Schmetzer and Hector Marinaro, and to you, the best fans in the league. Congratulations.
I'm in the green room. No, there's nobody in here yet. Yeah. Well, is that what you, I thought that's what you wanted to do. Fine. I've told Paul that we're waiting. I'll get him. I'll pull him again. A minute ago, I said, get him in here. Yeah. All right. No, that's okay.
There's the final tally, the Crunch, a four-point win for their second championship 2 years apart. They knock off the Kansas City Attack, and the celebration continues here at the CSU Convocation Center. That's the immediate reaction. Marinaro getting a ride from his teammates. Just a sweet victory, and the man of the match, Zoran Karic. There's the dynamic duo celebration. Let's head down to the locker room area with Greg Mace and the commissioner.
All right, well, the atmosphere is just as exciting. We're going to let the commissioner, Steve Paxos, present the trophy one more time. Steve? The George Hoffman.
Oh, okay.
George? Who's
this? On behalf of the NPSL, with my pleasure, I would like to present the 1996 championship trophy to honor George Hoffman of the Cleveland Crunch.
Thank you very much.
Coach Miller, co-captains Andy Schmetzer and Hector Marinaro, and to all the great fans of Cleveland that showed up tonight. Thank you.
There you go. Let's talk to some of the players here. Otto, come on in here. Otto Orff, you guys shut him down for the second half, part of the second quarter. What went through your mind defensively? You knew you had to shut him down at the end.
We had some guys on my back after the first half, but I tell you what, I didn't have to make a lot of saves in the second half. These guys were diving all over the place, throwing their bodies everywhere, from forwards to defenders. Everybody was giving their best on defense, and they did a great job.
Andy, where's Andy Schmetzer here? There he is. This is the team captain who had to sit out with the fractured eye socket here. Andy, I know you were frustrated. It was a great moment for you, though.
It was tough to watch the whole playoffs, but these guys are the best bunch of guys I ever played with. They kept me involved totally, and it was just great to watch that, especially that fourth quarter. These guys are the best, I tell you, they're the best.
Owner George Hoffman, a lot of character on this team. Compare that first championship to this one for me.
I beg your pardon. Compare
the first championship now to this one. What's the difference, if anything?
What's the difference is a lot of difference. We played with one of our better players, which was Andy Schmetzer, and everybody stepped up their game to fill in for Andy, and you could see that they wanted it very badly. Whereas the last time we also wanted it very badly, and we had Andy, which is a big help. So you could see that the team rallied upon their captain, and he was there to help them.
Bruce Miller, come on over here, coach, first year coach Bruce Miller. Congratulations. All right, you're down and out as you go to the locker room. You got the one goal. What did you tell this team at halftime?
Well, just the fellas, they knew how to play, and if they went back and defended, and
it's the smoke screen you threw up in the second half.
Yeah, if they went, we went back and defended, and we didn't, they didn't get any points in the second half, the veteran players stepped up, and our young rookies came to play, and it was a total team effort. You know, like I said, I think the crowd got us a little excited in the first half, and you want to perform for the crowd, so we all went forward like crazy and forgot about defending a little bit. And when we got, it was a little bit of a wake-up call at halftime, and we said a few things. I talked to the general manager, Al, and he suggested I say a few more things, so we went back and said a few more things, and
you were intense on the bench. Hector, come on in here. Hector Marinaro. Let's talk a little bit about what happened there in the second half, because you guys had so many chances, and it seemed like the shots that often would go in for you weren't going in. Phillips played a great game.
They sure did. The whole Kansas City team played a great game. They had an unbelievable season, and that second half was just unbelievable. We just wouldn't quit, and this team's got a lot of heart, and we weren't going
to
die.
It's been a lot of emotion for you this year with the birth of your son. You went up to greet your family. It's a great moment, I think, for you personally.
Yeah, the only downside is that my wife and my son couldn't be here tonight, but I just got off the phone with them, and they're happy. And the last 3 months have been hectic, but it was worth it. The little boy's home now, and that's all that counts.
Hector, congratulations. Congratulations, men. All right, second championship in 3 years. Head back to you.
All right, thanks a lot, Greg. You know what I think, Art, is one thing that stands out, it's a little different than they won it a couple of years ago, and it was in double overtime, but last year Hector was the hero. This year Zoran steps up, and he's the man at the end.
Well, the two guys that came through all season long, and I tell you what, I want to get down in the locker room. It's mellow down here. These fans are going absolutely crazy in Cleveland.
So the Crunch are the 1996 champs by virtue of a 16-12 victory. They win it 4-2, winning 4 straight after being down 0-2 in the series. They will look to defend next year. For Greg Mace, Art Kramer, and all the great crew here at ESPN2 and Verus Communications, I'm Ed Vasinic saying so long from Cleveland. It's party time. Okay.